The Aryan Khan case has now reached the doors of the Supreme Court. And how? The Shiv Sena leader Kishore Tiwari has moved the Supreme Court seeking protection of the fundamental rights of superstar Shah Rukh Khan's son Aryan Khan. In his plea, the Sena leader has also sought an investigation into the NCB activities, alleging that zonal director Sameer Vankhede was going after specifically stars in the film industry because his actor wife could not make it big in the industry. Kishore Tiwari has sought a Supreme Court mandated judicial probe after urging CJI N.V. Ramana to take suo motu cognizance of the Cruise drug bust case. Earlier, Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray accused the Narcotics Control Bureau of deliberately targeting the celebrities. He said there was an effort to create an impression that Maharashtra has become a hub of the narcotic substances. Aryan Khan, just giving you a background, was arrested on 3rd of October and will be in prison at least till tomorrow when the hearing comes up. And that a Mumbai court is likely to give an order on that bail plea after the arguments concluded. The Narcotics Control Bureau had arrested Khan after conducting a raid on the Cordelia Cruises Empress ship off the Mumbai coast.
संपूर्ण जगात माझ्या महाराष्ट्रामध्येच गांजा चरस ह्याचा व्यापार तुफान चाललेला आहे असं सगळीकडे चाललेलं आहे बरं असं काही नाहीये की केवळ महाराष्ट्रामध्येच तुम्हाला हे सगळं सापडते हे दोन बातमी आणखीन आहेत एक म्हणजे मुंद्रा अदानी बंदराचा तपास करा हे कोर्टाने सांगितलेलं तिकडे करोडो रुपयाचा अंमली पदार्थांचा साठा सापडलेला आहे करोडो रुपये कुठे येतो हे मुंद्रा आणि अदानी बंदर तुम्ही इकडे चिमुटभर गांजा तुम्ही म्हणजे ते हुंगत असताना माझ्या पोलिसांनी 150 कोटी रुपयाची ड्रग्स मुंबईत जप्त केलेली आहेत कोणाला तरी एक सेलिब्रिटी घ्यायचा आणि त्याच्या त्याला पकडला म्हणून ढोलकी वाजवायची फोटो काढून घ्यायचे
Let's go across to our legal correspondent Anisha Mathur reporting on the same. Anisha, this is big to be moving the Supreme Court via a political party. How does that work out? What precisely has been mentioned in what and has been applied to the court?
Well, this is a letter petition that has been sent by Kishore Tiwari, who's a Shiv Sena leader, who holds an MOS rank, according to his letter that has been sent to the Chief Justice's office. Now, they've raised two specific things. One, that the fundamental rights of Aryan Khan have been violated because he has been kept in police custody and then judicial custody for over 17 days. And the court, instead of passing an order on his bail plea, has simply deferred the order even after hearing full arguments. That is the legal aspect of it. The second aspect is the allegations that have been raised against the NCB itself. What this petition claims is that the NCB officer responsible for this entire probe has been unfairly and malafidely targeting celebrities, particularly in Mumbai, and for the sake of a vendetta. And in fact, very interestingly, this letter petition also claims that this is being done because of a vendetta, because the officer concerned has a spouse who is also involved in the film industry. Now, whether or not the Apex Court will take cognizance remains to be seen. This letter has been sent early this morning.
Yes.
But letter petition
do help us understand this, Anisha. How is perhaps the letter that is written by a political party over a case they are not directly a party to, as opposed to filing a proper PIL or any other legal way to approach the court?
Well, those are completely different things.
Yes.
Political person. Remember, this has not been filed through the political party. This has been filed by Kishore Tiwari in his personal capacity, saying that he, as a political leader, okay, as a somebody who is an activist,
yes,
is deeply disturbed by the fact that the fundamental rights of a 23-year-old have been violated,
okay,
by a government organization that is acting in a malafide manner. Now, this is his argument. Now, on the other hand, it's a writ petition that is filed for the sake of protecting somebody's fundamental rights. But in that case, someone who is directly connected with the petition, with the affected, has to have filed this kind of a writ petition.
Yes. Anisha, thank you for all the latest on that. It's very, very interesting what Anisha is telling us. Nevertheless, there is a politician who has approached the court and has said that fundamental rights of Aryan Khan are being infringed upon. Giving you a background, his hearing has been concluded for now on October 20th, which is tomorrow. We are expecting an order to come in by the judge. Now, parents, meanwhile, superstar of the film industry, Shah Rukh Khan, globally renowned, his producer wife, Gauri Khan, will of course be expecting a respite tomorrow. The Khans hope that their son will be out of custody before the Diwali festival. We're also being told by some of our insider information that, of course, the family is of course praying that the custody does get over. Mother Gauri Khan is keeping fasts at the residence Mannat for her son during the Navratri festival. Gauri Khan has also issued a diktat to her staff that no sweet dish will be cooked or coming into the house until Aryan Khan is released. An insider source has also revealed to India Today that there was an incident where she found that was the staff, we are being told, was cooking some sweet dish like kheer or something on the menu. It was immediately instructed for the staff that that will only happen once their child is out of the prison. An insider reveals that the mood at Mannat has been gloomy and somber. Despite the festivities all across the country, Shah Rukh Khan and Gauri have not made either a public presence or in no mood to celebrate either. Mannat has, remember, often been decorated and lit up for festivals like Eid and Diwali. There are crowds thronging at their gates all the time, clicking pictures. But for now, they will wait for some good news to come in. And then perhaps we are being told that the lights will go up at the Mannat residence.